Muawiyah.
Yeah.
What's his name?
Who?
I mean, sorry. Muawiyah didn't hate Ali.
No.
Here's another hadith.
Which, read it, read it.
It was narrated by Sayyid bin Jubair, said, I was with Ibn Abbas in Arafat, and he said, why do I not hear people reciting Talbiyah?
Yeah.
I said, they are afraid of Muawiyah. So Ibn Abbas went out of his tent and said, Labbaik Allahumma Labbaik. They are only forsaking the Sunnah out of hatred for Ali.
Okay, which hadith book has come from?
Sunan Nisa'i 3006.
Okay, so what does this hadith prove?
That he hated Ali.
Okay, first of all,
telling people to leave Talbiyah.
Who?
Muawiyah.
Where's the evidence for that?
It's written here. I said they are afraid of Muawiyah. So even
but it doesn't. It doesn't say. First of all, let's stick to the hadith. Mm-hmm. Let's assume it's authentic. Mm-hmm. I haven't checked yet if it's authentic. What is the authenticity? The Arabic. Graded Hassan. Okay, so it is basically by who? Yeah, that's a good question. Graded Hassan. Okay. Okay. So this hadith now, amazingly, this hadith is amazing. It's amazing for a number of reasons. One, when we break it down, okay, it explains to us what's going on. Number one, Ibn Abbas, he asks, why are you not saying Talbiyah? Right? And then they tell him, because they are scared of Muawiyah. Mm-hmm. Right? Now, we have no evidence that the Muawiyah forbade them to do Talbiyah. We don't know the context. We have to go and check. Number one. Number two, what does Ibn Abbas do?
He went out of the city and said, Labbaik Allahumma Labbaik.
So he's challenging Muawiyah. So clearly, there are people around at that time who have the courage to challenge Muawiyah. Okay? Now, my question comes back to Hassan. Was Hassan one of those people?
Yes, he went and he was going to do, what's it called?
Because this
he was going to do Siffin 2, isn't it?
Siffin 2?
Yeah, he was going to.
So what happens?
But then he, Muawiyah...
No. First of all, we don't know the chronology of this hadith. Mm-hmm. What year of Muawiyah's reign was this happening? Mm-hmm. And what is the context? The point here is, Ibn Abbas is directly challenging, according to this hadith, Muawiyah. If Muawiyah is responsible. If he's responsible. Because people are scared, they can be scared for a number of reasons. And they should be scared of the ruler. 100%. If they are not scared of the ruler, what's going to happen? Have you been to Dubai?
I have been to Dubai. Okay. Back in 2010.
Have you been to Dubai recently?
Yes. No, not recently.
Dubai is one of the most organized cities in the world. All credit goes to the ruler. The ruler is truly feared. Sheikh Rashid Al Maktoum. Again, I'm not saying he's the best ruler, he's the most. I'm saying he is truly feared. And because of his fear, the law works, the policemen are doing their job, the people don't break the law, they don't commit crimes because the system is so strong. So here, if people are scared of Muawiyah, that in itself is not necessarily. Why they are not saying Talbiyah? What Muawiyah had commanded, what was the context? Unless you present the context, we don't know. I haven't checked. I'm going to go and check. I'm going to go and check the sharah.
Another question.
Okay, no,
why
wait.
Ibn Abbas saying he's forsaking the sunnah of hatred of Ali?
Who's forsaking?
For
who is forsaking?
They, the people. Hatred for Ali.
Okay, so now good. Here, this is clearly happening during the reign of Muawiyah, okay? And a lot of people in the army of Muawiyah, who are they? They are the ones who fought in the Battle of Siffin, right? And they have this misconception that Ali bin Abi Talib radiallahu anh was responsible for the murder of Uthman. You know about this?
Yes.
Yes? They accused him of fostering and giving refuge to the killers of Uthman. So this hatred, you cannot just remove it, okay? I'm not making excuses for them. I'm trying to explain the context that if this is true, again, I have to check the authenticity properly and the context of the hadith. I'm only trying to make sense of it, that if it's true, there are clearly people in the army of Muawiyah.
And what if Muawiyah and Abu Sufyan also hated Ali?
I have no evidence for that. There's no evidence. No. There is no evidence. You cannot bring any direct. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. That you cannot bring.
What if I'm saying? What if?
There's no what if in Islam. What if we? What if? The, wait. What if does not give us our akidah?
Okay.
So you bring something specific. For example, I'll give you something. Sahih Muslim, when Muawiyah radiallahu an asked Saad bin Abi Waqqas radiallahu an, you can take this water. Saad bin Abi Waqqas radiallahu an, you can take it. It's mine.
It's yours.
He asked him, why do you not do sub? Why do you not do sub of Abu Turab or Ali bin Abi Talib radiallahu an? This is now something we can talk about.
Yes, because
there's a clear hadith in Sahih Muslim where Muawiyah.
Okay, now. Which says,
how does engineer translate this word sub?
Into cursing, yes. I know.
No. Urdu word. The Urdu word he uses.
Lana, maybe?
Galia. What does Galia mean? He's important so that we can explain what's happening here. What does Galia mean?
Galia means bad words, cursing.
No, Galia means mother this, mother F, mother F that. Galia, what is a swear word in English? In Urdu, would you say swearing is Galia in English? In Urdu.
Swearing.
Who knows Urdu?
Yeah.
Engineer uses the word Galia.
Can you show me
the clip?
Yeah,
go and check. Don't check now. Go and check. I'm making this claim that he uses the word Galia. Galia, which means swear words. Okay.
I've heard him say Lana.
I'm not talking about Lana. I'm saying when he says Galia, he translates the word sub as Galia. Okay.
There's also while Islam said Lana Allahu Abu Turab in Sahih Muslim.
That's not Muawiyah. That's not Muawiyah. That hadith is not about Muawiyah.
Yeah, not about
okay,
Muawiyah,
that's
no.
not about. And those people who did this, those people who did this, their affair is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they are guilty of hating a believer, a mu'min, someone like Ali bin Abi Talib radiallahu anhu. Anyone who hates him cannot have belief. So these people.
The turk of this hadith is in Musnad Ahmad.
So the point.
One second, please. Yeah. Another turuk of this hadith we're talking about is in Musnad Ahmad.
I have a very easy way to deal with these problems. If we believe Mirza Engineer and people like him, the Shia, who claim that Muawiyah.
He's not a Shia.
I'm not saying he's Shia, but he's something. He's neither Shia nor Sunni, he's Sushi. Yes. Okay? People like that, we call them Sushi. Okay, Sushi is a mixture of Sunni and Shia. Okay? Sushi. Right? So, my question to you is now, what's the best way to determine whether Muawiyah was actually doing this? Asking people to curse or swear at Muawiyah?
This hadith which you quoted?
No, it doesn't. It doesn't prove anything.
No, I'll tell you, there's another turuk in Musnad Ahmad.
Let me complete. Yeah.
Which says, after the Sahabi gave the reply to Muawiyah, after that day, Muawiyah never cursed Ali.
You will throw things at me until we know the authenticity. If it's not Sahih, we don't have to address it. If it's Sahih, then we will address it. Like Sahih Muslim, we are addressing the Sahih Muslim hadith, right? Even 2812, last time you came, people were saying 2812, Bukhari, 2812, we need to address it. We will address it in a minute. Okay.
And I'll show you more turuk of that hadith.
Turuk means nothing. If it's not authentic, it means nothing.
Okay.
Turuk means a chain.
A chain.
If it's not authentic, it's nothing.
Another
we don't need it. It doesn't do anything. We will only address authentic evidence.
Yes, of course.
Authentic evidence is Sahih Muslim. You're not letting me answer. Wait. In Sahih Muslim, that hadith, it gives us an anecdote, a story about two people talking to each other. Muawiyah and Saad bin Abi Waqqas. This is not a public discussion. This is not a public, and it's been reported. Okay. Now, was this a policy in the time of Muawiyah? It's a good question. Yes? Yes or no? Was this a policy? Cursing or swearing at Ali bin Abi Talib, as Shias and Mirza Engineer claim. Okay. The answer is with two people, Hassan and Hussein. For the first 10 years, Hassan is alive. For the second 10 years, Hussein is alive. Hussein is alive for all the 20 years of Muawiyah. Were there curses? Oh my God, please, not this guy. Okay, leave it. this continues, this keeps happening. Oh, this keeps happening. I told him not to, yeah. So, Hassan and Hussein, they are living in Medina. Yes? You know about this?
Yeah.
Turn, just come here. They are living, Hassan Hussein, living in Medina. And they have well-wishers in the whole Muslim Ummah. Yes? And they would know Muawiyah. Did they know that Muawiyah is getting their father cursed from the member or not? So they kept quiet.
No, that's why Karbala happened.
No, 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 no. Karbala happened in the time of Yazid. No, 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 no. Wait, wait, wait. 20 years of Muawiyah. The claim is, the Shia and engineer Muhammad Ali Mirza, their claim is that Muawiyah is getting Ali ibn Abi Talib cursed from the member. That's his claim. He has made this claim. And the Shias also make this claim. My question now. Wait, wait. Let's go step by step. Did Hassan and Hussein know this?
Yes.
Then there are two options. A'udhu billah, thumma a'udhu billah. Either it did not happen or they are both cowards.
No, they're not cowards. My question to you is...
Which option is correct?
Do you have any evidence that he didn't curse Ali?
Those who are making the claim, they need to bring evidence that Muawiyah gave direct orders to the imams in the entire ummah to curse Ali from the member. There is no such thing. What they quote is a conversation between and sub means to criticize. Because sabbahuma, Rasulullah used the same words against the Persian messengers. Sabbahuma, sabbahuma. So now we cannot imagine the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam swearing or cursing people. Likewise, Muawiyah is talking to Sa'd bin Abi Waqqas that why do you not criticize him or rebuke him, right?
Why?
Because Muawiyah and Ali are two parties fighting each other. Okay? They are in conflict. It is but natural that you criticize each other. People today, look what's happening.
Who was on the right side?
Okay. That point is not, it's called Fitnatul Kubra, Al Fitnatul Kubra. Right and wrong is not established as yet.
Wait. Says that
no, it's not. To you, it's clear because we know the history. We know what happened afterwards. We know what Yazid did. We know all those
Yazid
things.
Correct?
Of course not. Don't jump from. Look, stay on the topic.
Stay on
one issue. Don't jump from topic to topic. Okay? So the question now is Muawiyah getting Ali bin Abi Talib cursed from the member. I'm asking you a question. I ask you a question. Did Hassan and Hussein know, radiallahu anhuma, or did they not know? You said they know.
Yeah,
then if they know, there are two options. A'udhu billah, thumma a'udhu billah, they are cowards.
They're not cowards.
They're not cowards. Or it didn't happen. Because if they know, and they don't come out and stand up and stop this happening against their father, then they are definitely cowards. I'll tell you why. Because Hussein, he came out to fight Yazid. He came out against Yazid, yes? Yes? So we know he's not a coward. He wouldn't say... Relax. Focus on me. Relax.
Yeah, I'm relaxed.
Take a break. Stay with me. No, you're thinking. You're thinking. You're not listening.
I'm listening.
While I'm speaking, you're thinking.
I have questions, then I'll get
Yeah, you first. Stand here. In front of me. So that you can see me.
Calm down.
Okay.
I'm calm.
Yeah. So relax. First of all, go with me step by step. Then before we open another can of worms.
Wait. You said one thing. You said that it's not abusing.
I am not finished with my first point. Wait.
Here it says abusing.
Okay.
The translation
It's English,
says
brother. Sub. The sub in Arabic means criticizing. Rebuking. Khalas, so don't worry about it. Don't use Arabic English translations. Uh-huh. Just like engineers uses Urdu translations to do tafsir of the Quran. The Quran was revealed in Urdu for engineer Mirza. Okay. So the point is, Hassan and Hussein, we know they were not cowards. If they saw anything wrong, they would stand up against it. For example, they knew the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam: "Man raa minkum munkaran falyughayyirhu biyadihi, fa in lam yastati' fa bilisanihi, fa in lam yastati' fa biqalbi." You see an evil, stop it with your hands. Get involved. Don't sit idle when you see an evil. Okay, if you cannot do that, then speak up against it. If you cannot do that, then think of it as something evil in your heart. وَذَلِكَ أَدْعَفُ الْإِيمَانِ And this is the weakest level of Iman. We believe Hussein and Hassan were on the highest level of Iman, right? If they saw this happening against their father. Okay, wait, relax. Wait. They would, I'm claiming, they would rise up. They would tell all those governors and Muawiyah and his so-called cronies to stop this or there will be consequences. But they don't do that. This is why I believe this is a lie. It never happened because this is why there's no evidence for it.
Okay.
From the time of
Another
Muawiyah.
In Musnad Ahmad.
Okay, pull it out. Don't talk. No. Pull it out. If you don't have it, don't talk about it. Don't bring it up. If you don't have it, bring it back. Bring it in Arabic. Bring it in English translation. And then the hukam. Where is it, whether it's authentic or not.
Okay.
For now, we suspend judgment on this issue. Mm-hmm. Why? For you to prove that in the time of Muawiyah, Ali radiallahu anh was being cursed from the minbar and Hassan and Hussein still continued to receive money from him. That was coming from Baytul Mal, no doubt. Mm-hmm. This wasn't Muawiyah's money.
Was in the Quran,
No.
Yes,
they,
it is in the Quran.
What's that?
You have to give the Baytul Mal to the...
But why, Muawiyah, why would he care about the Quran? Why would Muawiyah care about the Quran? He's getting Ali cursed. He's a criminal. He's a conspirer. Why would he care about the Quran and send them money? He would tell them, get these two guys removed. Move them. Kill them. He didn't do that, right? So
then
we know.
Hassan.
Huh? Who said that? Well, I know the stories. History. Forget to hell with history.
Yeah.
Tell me who said that he was. Hassan radiallahu anh died of natural causes. Wait, relax. Let me finish the
joke. Come on. Yeah.
There are reports that he was poisoned. Mm-hmm. Okay, and then Hassan radiallahu anh was asked by Hussein on his deathbed, who did it? Tell me. I will not tell you why. Why? What is Hassan saying? Why?
Because if yes, I know.
Yes. So if Hassan, those Shias and engineers and engineer bachas and all those guys online. Wait. All those guys behaving like scholars and philosophers and historians. They've just suddenly put on the turban on their heads and they become the Sheikh al-Islam, not knowing basic things, right? If there is no evidence that Muawiyah had him killed or poisoned, then if you are wrong, on the day of judgment, you will be done for slander. You'll be done. So zip your mouth. Because Hussein was there, who interviewed his brother when he was dying. Okay? If Hussein had believed that Muawiyah is responsible, he would never remain silent. So all these things you cannot ignore, my brother. The story is far too long and far too much. What people like engineer have done, they have made a murakkab of different sources and different reports, mixed.
Achha, let's talk mixed. About 2812.
Yeah, let's do it. So, 2812.
How will you interpret 2812, Bukhari 2812?
I have a very simple understanding of it. They were Khawarij in the army of Ali. Mm-hmm. Yes or no? Mm,
yes.
They were Bughat.
Yes.
Yes?
Yes.
And the Prophet said, the Baghi group, the Bughat, taqtuluka fi'atul Baghiya. Okay, oh Ammar, you will be killed by the rebellious group. Okay, there are reasons to believe that one of these people killed Ammar. So this is why we cannot apply the hadith on Muawiyah and
this
Ali ibn Abi.
No.
No, Siffin. Wait. Who is fighting in Siffin? Wait. Wait.
Muawiyah's army and Ali ibn Abi Talib.
And Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anh, whose army, how many groups are there? Who are there?
How many groups are there? I don't know.
Are the Khawarij there?
Yes.
Khawarij are there?
Oh, yeah.
Khalas. How many are there, at least?
I mean, I don't have a number.
10,000. At least 10,000. How do we know the numbers? Because in the Battle of Nahrawan, the same Khawarij fought Ali ibn Abi Talib. 10,000 of them. All of them were killed but 9 in this battle. Okay? So 9,991 were killed. Right? Only 9 remained alive. Okay? So now, these Khawarij, wait. In the Battle of Siffin, okay, Ammar bin Yasir is killed. Okay? We know Muawiyah did not give any direct orders. In fact, they were disturbed. When the news came to Muawiyah and Amr bin As radiallahu anh, Amr said, Ammar has been killed. Okay, And Abdullah bin Amr bin Ash radiallahu
anhu. What did Muawiyah reply to?
First of all, let's be fair. Muawiyah receives the news. What does he do? He says, yeah, I got him killed. No. He's going to say, hold on. First of all, in the response of Muawiyah is basically his disapproval, number one. Why? Because he's disowning. He's disowning. He's saying, I didn't kill him. I didn't want him to be killed. Radiallahu anhu. Wait. In the response of Muawiyah, because you can have two readings. You can have an upside down reading or you can have the straight reading. Okay, you can have a twisted reading. The twisted reading is of Shia and people like Engineer. Oh, look, he's blaming Ali bin Abi Talib. I'll explain to you what he's doing.
Can I read the hadith for the public?
28:12.
28:12, but it's in Musnad Ahmad.
No, no, why are you reading? No, Bukhari, read.
Bukhari, 20. Knows
oh, Bhaijan, you're reading. No, no, 28:12.
28:12, everyone knows.
No, so why? What are we discussing?
It is, but this is a different turuq.
No. Why are you reading a different turuq? It may not be authentic. Musnad has.
Check it. It is authentic.
You said 28:12. That's Bukhari.
But there are.
Wait. Why not Bukhari?
I'll read you the Bukhari.
Okay, Bukhari. Go. We're discussing Bukhari. Pani basni. Baitha hai kafi peeta hai. Haan, wo puri botol si mere kol kidhar gayi hai.
तो
गायब हो गई है नहीं इधर ही सी नहीं बस मैं नहीं खत्म करके बस कॉफी शॉपी पीने
उमर ही विल बी किल्ड बाय रिबेलियस अग्रेसिव ग्रुप उमर विल इनवाइट
अग्रीड सो वन ऑफ द रीजंस वी एक्सप्लेन वन ऑफ द वेज वी एक्सप्लेन दिस इज इट कैन नॉट बी मुआविया
व्हाई
नो इट कैन नॉट बी मुआविया बिकॉज़ वी
वन ऑफ द
I have two reasons. Let me understand. 28:12 is a very clear report that identifies the people who will kill him. Okay? It was not Muawiyah because of the reasons I already explained, that there were 10,000 Khawarij in the army of Ali and one of them killed Ammar bin Yasir radiallahu anhu. Okay? Number one. Okay. I'll tell you why. Because we have reasons to believe in reports that the Khawarij did not want the Muslims to unite. They wanted the conflict to escalate. This is why they shot arrows at the army of Aisha radiallahu anha before the Battle of Jamal. They had already agreed to do what? They had agreed, Ali bin Abi Talib had agreed with Zubair and Talha radiallahu anhuma that we will punish the killers of Uthman.
At night
what happens? Arrows. And then the army of Aisha start fighting back, and then the army of Ali start fighting, and then Ali.
The hadith of hope, then?
You open another topic now. That hadith doesn't do nothing to the status of Aisha. It only identifies the woman who was going out.
It doesn't. But she was on the wrong side.
Can I say something?
Listen.
These Khawarij.
Yeah.
They were not formed during Safin. They were formed after Safin. How can you say that Khawarij were within the army of Ali during Safin?
I have a response to that. The Khawarij were already there before Safin and before Ali became caliph, because these are the same people who killed Uthman. They are the ones who came from Misr, from Egypt and Iraq, and some of them were from Yemen. They besieged the house of Uthman and they killed him. They were Bughat. And they forced Ali bin Abi Talib to take the bayah. Okay, and then they joined his army, and they were basically blackmailing him with their numbers, and they were a troublesome lot.
But you know, Muhammad bin Abi Bakr was also one who entered the
house.
He held his beard, and that on that Uthman said, you know, if your father was alive, he would not have liked that.
So yes.
So it means that just saying that only Khawarij were like, I think they were maybe Sahaba, children of Sahaba.
Who?
The Khawarij.
No, they were not.
Egypt.
They were not. They came from Egypt, from Iraq, and they were all new converts, and they were excited like we have some young boys here running around. They read two pamphlets on Islam and they put a topi on their head and they start giving fatwa. So this is the type of people they were.
Sayyidina Uthman's foster brother, he was drunk and he prayed.
But what's your point? That they were not Khawarij?
No, I'm saying that the demand of the Farid were to remove the caliph. They were not like miscreants.
Uthman. So you are now conceding that the Khawarij were there?
No, I do not think they were Khawarij.
They are the ones who were called Bughat. You know Malik al-Ashtar.
Yeah,
he was the leader.
He was in the army.
What did Ummul Mu'mineen, I forgot, Umm Salama, she say about him?
What did she say?
There's a report about Malik Ashtar. Malik Ashtar is a very controversial figure, very much condemned.
Yes. Yeah. I'm going to quote this hadith from Musnad Ahmad.
Okay.
The same talk.
But why Muslim? Hold on. When we have Bukhari, why are you going to Musnad?
Because
what's your game? No. What is your game?
No,
it's okay, but not every hadith is okay in Musnad.
No,
because what happens? I'll tell you why. This young man is a student. This young man is a young man. Okay, so a lot of the young men or young brothers do, they have a hodgepodge, okay, a cocktail of hadiths. They will take an authentic hadith. And then they will bring something. They will bring something from an unauthentic source, which has a longer story.
Can you read out the hadith, brother?
First, you tell us. Why are you not reading Bukhari?
I already read Bukhari.
Everywhere we go, engineers clan or his cult. Followers, not you. 2812. 2812. Abhi, why are you not quoting from it?
I did quote from 2812, but Abhi, understand the context. We have to take all the references.
It's useless to talk about him.
Yes,
understand the context.
Allah has dealt with him.
From all the books.
Allah has dealt with him. When Allah humiliates someone, no one can save him. So he's been humiliated. Allah has dealt with him. Engineer.
I have a different take on it. You know, the way he has totally stood with the military establishment. So I don't care about that.
Yeah. I care about what he's been saying for years about Muawiyah and Sahaba and Imams and mocking people like Ibn Taymiyyah. I wouldn't hire him as a cleaner in my house.
Listen, even
as my driver.
Listen, Uncle, what engineer said, I think it was already said by Maulana Ishaq as well.
Maulana Ishaq
was a nobody. Maulana Ishaq was a nobody. Engineer made him famous. Engineer made him his teacher. Engineer ke teachers kaun hai? Le deke paanch. Kya bolta hai? Peer Nasiruddin. Okay. And amazingly, let me tell you something. This is a joke. He says, my teachers are Peer Nasiruddin, Dr. Asrar Ahmed. Okay. अच्छा जावेद गांधी भी है लेकिन उसको काउंट नहीं करता बीच में
इसका वो कौन है
आई डोंट केयर
अरे नहीं भाई मेरा वो फोन खोला था तो पिक्चर दिखती थी सो इसकी बिना करने का
क्या
फोन में
क्या हुआ
मतलब इसमें वो खुल गई थी पिक्चर
आई डोंट थिंक पीपल विल विल आस्क हिम टू ब्लर दिस इंशाल्लाह टेल हिम व्हेन यू सी हिम इंशाल्लाह ओके नाउ द इशू इज नाउ माय क्वेश्चन इज that Maulana Ishaq and people like him were completely unknown. No one, mostly speaking in Punjabi and doing Urdu speeches. Usko engineer ne jaan boojh ke mashhoor kiya. Kyun? He was completely rejected by most scholars around that area. I knew him before engineer made him famous. Okay? He was called Ishaq Jhalwala. Okay? Aur wo baba jo hai, he was completely rejected by most of the scholars around there and they called him misguided. Gumrah, because of the same narrative engineer later on adopted and promoted. So this is the problem.
Even Maulana Mududi was rejected when he wrote...
Because Maulana Mududi was heavily criticized and corrected and he was absolutely wrong about all those things he attributed to the Sahaba and Khilafat or Mulukiyat. He was completely... Engineer is an insincere guy. If he was sincere, you know, there was a huge thorough response against Maududi's Khilafat al-Mulukiyat by a Pakistani scholar called Salahuddin Yusuf, rahmatullah alayh. He passed away. And he showed how Maududi sahab, Allah have mercy on him, we pray for him, how he actually used complete lies to criticize the Sahaba from history, books of history, from Tabri, reports from Tabri, and reports from some other sources. Okay, and I read Khilafat al-Mulukiyat myself. It's absurd. इट्स फुल ऑफ. सो मौदूदी साहब की जो है ना वो फील्ड नहीं थी साइंस और हदीस. मौदूदी साहब ने तफसीर लिखी है, अल्लाह उनको जज़ाए खैर अता फरमाए. तफहीमुल कुरान ही हैज़ रिटन दैट तफसीर, सो मे अल्लाह रिवॉर्ड हिम फॉर दैट. बट दैट डजंट मीन मौदूदी साहब वाज मासूम. मौदूदी साहब मेड मेनी मिस्टेक्स. कम बैक बिकॉज़ सम ऑफ द कैमरास कैन नॉट कैच आवर.
हु किल्ड अम्मार इब्न यासिर?
Abu Ghadia. Abu Ghadia, apparently Abu Ghadia. There's a report that says Abu Ghadia, yes.
And who was he fighting with?
He was on the side of Muawiyah radiallahu anhu. Right. Yes.
He was also from Rizwan.
But is this report authentic? First question.
We'll have to check it.
Number one. Number two.
Number two.
Another question I have is, okay, if Abu Ghadia kills him, okay,
then
how does that
group is rebellious, okay, and they are inviting Ammar ibn Yasir to hellfire.
But we have reasons to believe that he was killed by the Khawarij, who were part of the army of Ali ibn Abi Talib. Now we're not saying relax. We're not saying Ali is responsible for this. Likewise, if someone from Muawiyah, let's Abu Ghadia, let's say the hadith of the authentic, Abu Ghadia kills him, we cannot hold the entire army of Muawiyah accountable. Why? Wait, relax. Relax, yaar, or relax ho ja, khuda ke bande. Meri baat khatam ho. Let me finish my statement. Why? Because Hassan radiallahu anh, he gave bay'ah to same man. People like engineer and others like him criticize and disown and call him all sorts of things. Mamu party, yehi lagaya hua na, badtameezon ne. Yeah, Mamu party, yeah, right? So these people, on the day of judgment, they will pay for this Mamu party. They will pay because they are now insulting Hassan. Hassan, they are calling Hassan's Amir, Khalifatul Muslimin. Ji haan, absolutely. Amirul Mu'mineen. Bhaijaan, Amirul Mu'mineen. Amirul Mu'mineen.
When did I say Khalifa Rashid
to me? Okay, now this is amazing. You have raised a very interesting point. Who was Khalifa Rashid? Hassan.
Hassan.
The last one.
And what did the Prophet say about Khalifa al-Khulafa Rashidin?
It will be for 30 years and after that.
Wait. No. Alaykum bi sunnati. Wa sunnat. So he's one of the Khulafa Rashidin. And what is his sunnat? What is he doing? He's giving bayah to Muawiyah. So alaykum. Follow him. Follow Khalifa Rashid. Wait, relax. Follow Khalifa Rashid. Who said that? The Prophet. The Prophet is telling you to follow Hassan. And you're saying, no, you know what? No, wait. This guy, Muawiyah, killed Ammar. We're not going to forgive him. Wait, we're not going, even if we accept he did.
You cannot blindly follow a Khalifa. He has to follow Quran and Sunnah.
No. Stop it.
For example,
stop this. Relax.
Relax.
I am saying the Prophet said, Alaykum bi sunnati wa sunnati al-Khulafa al-Rashidin. Wait. It's absolute. I'll tell you how it's absolute. The Prophet is saying, upon you is my sunnah and the sunnah of my rightly guided caliphs, number one. Number two, the Prophet ﷺ endorses that very bay'ah. When Hassan radiallahu anh gave bay'ah to Muawiyah, the Prophet endorsed it. How? Inna ibni haza sayyidun.
Yeah, that I know.
La'alla Allah an yusliha bayna, an yusliha bihi bayna fiyatayn azimatayn. Azimatayn min al-Muslimin. Okay, now, the Prophet ﷺ is telling us that Hassan is Sayyid, he's honorable. Why? Because he will bring two great groups of Muslims together. Wait. Now, either this is wrong or this is a virtuous act. According to the Prophet ﷺ, this is virtuous. He's praising him for this. And as a result, what's the consequence of this? The consequence of this is Muawiyah becoming the Khalifa and Hassan becoming the follower. Okay, because Hassan is on the pulpit, he's on the member, he steps down. He comes down and he takes the hand of Muawiyah and brings him up. Okay, wait.
It doesn't.
Yehi to baat hai. Asal baat hi wahi. Sara masla hi hai. Isi pe to shiyon ki intellectual maut hai. Isi pe to mirza jaisa.
Iske baad jo kiya wo kaisa tha? How is
that? Oh, acha. Uske baad pe aajo. Pehle to chalo. Pehle. Bahut achhi baat hai. Iske baad pe aajo. Ab chalte hain baad mein. First of all, let us establish that after the bay'ah of Hassan with Muawiyah and accepting him as Amir al-Mu'mineen, the fight in Siffin and the killing of Ammar has all been neutralized, correct?
Okay.
Hassan ne bhai, when he did bay'ah on the hand of Muawiyah, those crimes no longer stand. They don't matter anymore. The crimes have been committed, according to the Shia and others, the crimes have been committed. The moment Hassan gives his hand into the hand of Muawiyah and accepts
his
oyar
sabr
pashto aati hai sabr rakhna kyunki urdu mein to tumhe samajh nahi aa rahi hai pashto mein samjhana padega.
Acha ek minute, I will tell you one thing about
aapne jo bola na, let me finish my point, it's very important. So after Hassan gives bayah to Muawiyah, so all the crimes Muawiyah has committed before, according to whoever claims, well, those crimes, they why? No, wiped out, why? Why? Because Khalifa Rashid is appointing him as Khalifa, Amir al-Mu'mineen. It's not an ordinary Tom Joe who comes along and says, put him on the member. No, it's Khalifa Rashid, Bhaijaan. Jiski guarantee Allah ke Nabi ne liya.
Appointment of his son, which was the Sunnah of Kaisar al-Kisra.
We're going to get to that. Amazing. Good point. Yeah. Let's get to that. Wait.
Hassan,
first of all, we need to wipe out his crimes before Khilafah. Correct? Because after Hassan gives bayah to him, clearly Hassan has made sulh and he has appointed him. He's rewarded him. Amazingly, he's rewarded him with Khilafah.
Why did he go to fight him again?
Relax. Are you not getting my point? Are you so stupid?
I understand.
Okay. So, mera point to suno na.
Aapka point sun liya bhai.
Pehle crime wipe out ho gaye.
Nahin hue wipe out.
Phir to Hassan criminal hai,
nauzubillah.
Summa nauzubillah. Phir to bade criminal Hassan hai.
Political pressure.
Bhai jaan, political pressure mein you cannot do kufr. Good. Muslim the. Or Khalifa Rashid appoints him as his Amir.
But
do Shias
believe
Muawiyah was Muslim?
No,
he is
a Kafir.
He is a Munafiq. So he dies, right? After Hassan's death, Shias finished. Their game is finished. Bhai, if Hassan, Imam Masoom, and Khalifa Rashid, according to us, is appointing a man as his Amir, game over. Making him Amir al-Mu'mineen, the leader of the believers. So he is giving. Wait. What is the title of the Amir? Khalifa. What is the title? Amir al-Mu'mineen.
Amir al-Mu'mineen.
Hassan is making him Amir al-Mu'mineen. Amir al-Mu'mineen is the leader of the believers, let alone a believer. He's a believer, and not only that, he's a leader of the believers. So, Hassan's license or his stamp on Muawiyah wipes out your claims against him and the claims of the Shia fraternity.
God has already decided, you guys are so stubborn.
Hassan is not
responsible for the judgment day.
No, wrong. Allah has already decided through the Prophet. I'm responding. Allah has already decided through the Prophet. The Prophet said, "Inna ibni haza sayyidun."
That's only about the sulah, the good act.
No, not sulah. This is what you don't understand. The consequences of the sulha and bayah. You don't understand, and you don't want to understand, because a bayah is not just a bayah. A bayah is appointing a man. Okay, if he's a criminal, he cannot be appointed. So clearly, Hassan did not judge him like the Shia and the engineer fraternity do.
Okay.
Hassan did not judge him like that.
Okay.
If Hassan did, ye engineer lota wahan pe hota. Ek minute. Ye engineer, agar engineer wahan pe hota, ye kya kehta hai? Ki main talwar utha ke main ladta Muawiya se. Isne kaha Amir, aur meri baat suno. Isne kaha Amir banana tha, Hazrat Muawiya. Agar isko, agar ye wahan badtameez khada hota Hazrat Hassan ke samne, to isne bandar ki tarah shakal banayi hoti. Ki ye kya kar rahe hain aap, Hazrat, ye kya kar rahe hain? Right?
I want to say one thing. Aap jo keh rahe the na, absolute obedience to the Khalifa Rashid.
Ek minute sabr karo. Ek minute sabr to karo. Mujhe aap batao. Ki agar engineer Hazrat Hassan ke saath khada hota, agar wo to nahi ho sakta, agar khada hota, तो उसकी शक्ल कैसी होती?
अरे भाई
नहीं सामने होती, लेकिन नहीं चलो अल्लाह ताला, मैं कहता हूँ उसको हिदायत दे अल्लाह, उसको अल्लाह, लेकिन लेकिन वो कह रहा है कि मैं तो तलवार से लड़ता, वो कह रहा है कि मुझे अगर वहाँ अल्लाह ने डाला, हम अल्लाह का शुक्र करते हैं कि अल्लाह ने हमें वहाँ नहीं डाला। हम भाई
अगर आप होते सिफीन के टाइम पे तो आप किसका साइड पे?
मैं होता ही ना सिफीन में,
क्यों नहीं होते?
बिल्कुल, बहुत सारे हजारों की तादाद में सहाबी सिफीन में नहीं थे, उन्होंने कहा हम नहीं लड़ते, बल्कि हदीस है बुखारी की भाई के एक सहाबी तलवार लेके निकले, उनसे पूछा मैं कहाँ जा रहे हैं, उन्होंने कहा कि फलाने की फौज में जा रहा हूँ, उन्होंने कहा रसूलुल्लाह का हुक्म सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम जी पीछे हो जाए,
उस वाली हदीस का क्या, वो जूते गाड़ने वाली हदीस
क्या हो, कौन सी हदीस? ओ भाई एक हदीस, द प्रॉब्लम विद यू गाइस इज आई गिव यू वन हदीस एंड देन यू जंप, ओ व्हाट अबाउट दैट वन, व्हाट अबाउट दैट वन, व्हाट अबाउट दैट वन, डील विद वन फर्स्ट इज कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस एंड देन वी गोना टॉक अबाउट।
एक मिनट मैं एक बात करना चाह रहा
हूं, आप यू डोंट हॉप फ्रॉम हदीस टू हदीस,
लेट मी से यू नो हजरत उमर सैयदना उमर ही टुक बैक मेनी डिसीजंस ड्यूरिंग हिज लाइफ ऑन क्रिटिसिज्म, you know that, so that yes. means there is no absolute obedience of the Khalifa Rashid, do you understand what I'm
yes.
saying?
Yes, I agree, but there is absolute obedience to the Prophet, you agree?
Yeah, yes, of course.
Okay,
not the Prophet, Khalifa Rashid.
Okay, wait. No, agree. Yes. But the Prophet said, "Inna ibni haza sayyadun." Why? Wait.
Let
me, yaar, aap sun nahi rahe meri baat. Aap mujhe finish nahi karne de rahe. आपको क्योंकि मेरी बातें आपको अच्छी नहीं लग रही, तो आप मुझे काट रहे हैं, आप मुझे काट रहे हैं, डोंट कट मी इन द मिडल, मे बी यू डोंट लाइक व्हाट आई एम सेइंग एंड यू कटिंग मी, ओके लेट मी एक्सप्लेन नाउ, द प्रॉफिट सेड इन्ना इब्नी हाजा सय्यदुन, व्हाई? बिकॉज ऑफ व्हाट हसन इज गोइंग टू डू, व्हाट इज ही गोइंग टू डू, वेट रिलैक्स, व्हाट इज ही गोइंग टू डू, क्योंकि यू आर अबाउट टू टॉक, यू सी यू आर नॉट लिसनिंग, यू आर थिंकिंग व्हाइल आई एम स्पीकिंग, यू आर थिंकिंग, स्टॉप थिंकिंग एंड लिसन टू मी, देन इट विल गेट इनटू योर माइंड. The Prophet is saying, "Inna ibni haza sayyidun." Why? Because of what he will do. What did he do? He not only joined hands; he gave bayah to Muawiyah. So this is what the Prophet is endorsing. He's endorsing the bayah of Muawiyah, making him a leader of the believers. Why? Because the hadith says, "Ain yusliha bihi bayna fiatain azimatain min al-Muslimin." So there are two, not one group. Alfiyatul Ula, Alfiyatul Thaniya. Number one group is Hassan, and number two group is Muawiyah radiallahu anhuma. And the Prophet is praising Hassan. Why? Because he will bring them together.
Okay. Your point.
That could only happen when Hassan steps down and Muawiyah becomes the Khalifa.
Easy question.
So this is not from the Khalifa. This is from Allah. Okay. This is from Allah.
Okay.
Told or said by the Prophet and fulfilled in Hassan and Muawiyah.
Okay.
Run around the world, you cannot escape this.
There is a difference of opinion. No. Your istidlal is that.
My istidlal is directly from the hadith.
Yeah, my istidlal is it's only about sulah. The Prophet appreciated.
No, it was a bayah. It wasn't a sulah necessarily. This bayah naturally came with the sulha. Sulha is secondary, bayah is primary. Because sulha you can make with kuffar. You can have a treaty with kuffar. But bayah is only given to a deserving Muslim leader. This is the problem. You don't understand the consequences of these reports. These Shias and the cronies, okay, they don't think about these things. The biggest blow to Shia fraternity is the bayah of Hassan to Muawiyah. And it is bayah because they play this game with the gullible followers that it's not bayah, it's sulha. Sulh you can do with anyone.
Wait, one thing. So was Yazid good? One question.
Yeah, what kind of question is it?
Was Yazid a good person?
Okay, now, so, okay, good.
Yazid was a sahaba.
Talk to me, what happened? You ask me the question.
Was Yazid good?
Okay. First of all, we finished with Muawiyah.
No, it is coming to Muawiyah.
Okay. So how is it coming to Muawiyah?
I'm going to
first of all,
yes no.
We deal with Muawiyah and then we go to Yazid.
Yes, we can
first
you tell
of
me,
all,
was Yazid good or bad?
Okay, first of all.
No, yes or no?
First of all.
What do you think? You're not answering.
I'm answering the question. It was bad. Now I'm gonna.
Oh,
wait, relax. I'm gonna bring back the question. Is Muawiyah endorsed by the Prophet of Allah? Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. It's Khalafa, his leadership. Yes.
I don't think so.
So you don't believe in the hadith?
I believe in the hadith.
I have a different opinion in the istidlal of the hadith.
No. There's no istidlal. Give me another istidlal. Go on. The hadith says,
yeah,
Allah this son of mine is an honorable son. He's an honorable man. Inna ibni haza sayyidun ay yusliha bihi bayna fi'atayn azimatayn min al-muslimin. Here, Allah's messenger is telling us Hassan is sayyid. He's great, he's honorable. Prophet, why? Why? Because of what he will do. What will he do? He will do, Allah will bring two groups of the believers together. As what? As a consequence of his bay'ah to Muawiyah. Muawiyah becomes Amir al-Mu'mineen and he steps down.
So, I think
so this in this Muawiyah hadith, there's an endorsement for Muawiyah.
The bay'ah of Sayyidina Ali, which was a big, big thing.
Yes.
You are clearly not following my discussion.
No, it proves to me,
because you're not listening to me. You are and no, the problem is they're not listening to me. They are both. I am saying, I'm making arguments, and they're not following the argument. My argument is all the things you will bring before Muawiyah's Khilafah, okay, have been wiped clean by the Sulh and the Bay'ah of Hassan. You are not following. You keep mentioning things before he became Khalifa, because Hassan would have known all these things. But you are refusing to accept Hassan's judgment. The problem is with you.
This is not about that.
It is about that. You're refusing to accept Hassan's judgment, which came from Allah.
Which came from Allah. Is that Hassan is also not masoom and khata as Shias believe.
The Prophet is. And the Prophet said, Inna ibni haza sayyidun.
So I believe
in yusliha bihi bayna azimatain.
It's about the Sulah. You
have a different opinion.
Believe the
same. But the मेरा दिमाग फट जाएगा. इन दोनों ने
ये
मेरी शुगर लगा
रहे. शुगर नहीं. मेरे सही में क्वेश्चंस है भाई. मुझे आंसर चाहिए. मैं
भाई, यू हैव नो आंसर्स टू दिस क्वेश्चन. यू कैन डांस अराउंड. तुम नाचो. यू गोना डांस अराउंड. अब देखा एक और. व्हाट अबाउट दैट हदीस. Or what about 6,000 hadiths in Sahih Bukhari? 7,552.
Wait. What about that hadith which says Khilafat Rashida will stay till 30 years and then Mulke Adnan will come? What about that?
Yaar, you are not listening
to me. My question is, what Mulke Adnan kaun tha? Who
was that? Listen. You are not listening to my argument, are you?
I am listening to your argument.
Okay. First of all, let's establish one by one. Is Muawiyah, radiallahu anhu, endorsed directly by the Prophet? And by extension, Allah. Is he or is he not? This is the first point. Once we establish this, sab kuch, inshallah, everything will become peaceful. Aman aur sukoon ho jayega. We're not going to any more hadith. Wait. Because there are 6,000 hadiths.
Exactly. Yeah. Yeah.
Look, where is the source?
So we
have to check the source. Look, coming back to my point, my question is very direct. Is Muawiyah and his leadership and his Khilafah endorsed by Allah, his messenger, and a Khalifa Rashid?
No.
Answer is no?
Then you are
denying Allah, you're denying his Prophet, and you're denying Khalifa Rashid.
He was a king.
He was a monarch.
You're not listening. Clearly, you're not listening to me. I'm going to repeat the same arguments. You're not listening to me. First of all, when the Prophet said, wait, relax. I'm going to repeat my argument.
He was the first monarch.
When the Prophet of Allah says something, is it from Allah or is it from his word? Relax. When the Prophet of Allah says something, is it from Allah or is it from the Prophet?
No, it's Allah. From Allah.
Because the Quran says, in Surah An-Najm, listen to me now. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وما ينطق عن الهوى إن هو إلا وحي يوحى. That Prophet does not speak from his desires. So when the Prophet said, when the Prophet said, إن ابني هذا سيد, okay, لعل الله أن يصلح به بين عزيمتين.
You have a problem.
You're not listening. You are ignoring my argument completely, and you're not registered for some reason. You know, wait, let me finish my point. You are ignoring my argument. Okay, then listen, let me repeat it. Qadianis, when I speak to Qadianis, they go brain dead like this. I'm giving them black and white. Simple arguments to follow. They go brain dead. Completely brain dead. That's not happening to you guys.
Bye.
Because you have a bias, you have a position, and you cannot see that position shattered.
Adnan bhai, aap
फिनिश कर लेंगे फिर आप हमें बोलने का मौका देंगे।
ठीक है, पहले तो आपने ओके फॉलो माय आर्गुमेंट,
आई एम फॉलोइंग योर
माय आर्गुमेंट इज
मैं आपका आर्गुमेंट बता
माय प्रीमिस माय प्रीमिस इज माय प्रीमिस इज मुआविया खिलाफा एंड हिज लीडरशिप वाज डायरेक्टली एंडोर्स्ड बाय अल्लाह His messenger and a Khalifa Rashid. Again, Dekha, you can't be quiet. You cannot be quiet. You cannot be quiet. You have a position. You've been brainwashed into a position, and you are not willing to let go of that position. You cannot believe that this position is being challenged directly from the Quran and the Sunnah. Okay, okay. I'm making a claim. Muawiyah's leadership and his Khilafa is directly endorsed by Allah, the Prophet of Allah. And Khalifa Rashid. Okay, now let me explain. Number one, Allah says, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam does not speak from his desires. So, what did the Prophet say about this? The Prophet said about this, Inna ibni haza sayyidun la'allallah an yusliha bihi bayna fiyatain azimatain min al-muslimin. This son of mine is an honorable man. Why? Because Allah will bring two great groups of Muslimin together through him. Through him. This is now in the endorsement of the Messenger of Allah on that very coming together and whatever that constitutes. Coming together of Hassan and Muawiyah and whatever it constitutes. What does it constitute? Hassan gives bayah to Muawiyah. And then who is Hassan? Hassan is Khalifa Rashid. He is the fifth Khalifa Rashid because the Prophet ﷺ said, Khilafatul Rashida, Khilafa after me is for 30 years. And Hassan is one of them. Hassan is what? Relax, one second. Yeah. Hassan, main khatam kar raha hu. No, relax. I'm making an argument, so I want to stick to this. Wait. So, Prophet ﷺ, he said it, and Hassan is Khalifa Rashid. And the Prophet said, follow him. Follow him when he does something, when he decides to follow him. And in this case, in this very case, the Prophet himself said, this will happen. This will happen and whatever happens is good. Why? Because my son is Sayyid. He's Sayyid because of what he will do. He will do what? He will give bayah to Muawiyah. He will give bayah to Muawiyah and make him Amir al-Mu'mineen, Khalifatullah. Okay. Wait, relax. I'm not finished. Relax. Then what happens? Khalifatul Rashid fulfills the prophecy of Rasulullah by that virtue, the words of Allah. Okay? And Allah endorses this action, the Prophet endorses this action, and Hassan fulfills it by giving bayah to Muawiyah. So when Muawiyah becomes Khalifatullah, he becomes Amir al-Mu'mineen. This is a deed, or this is an occurrence, this is an outcome that Allah has endorsed, the Prophet has endorsed, and the Khalifa Rashid endorsed. Okay, now, ab mera argument samajh aa gaya? Okay, wait. Okay, last one sentence. So whatever Muawiyah did before, all the wars, all the killings, all the disputes, they are completely cancelled out. Why? Because the Prophet ﷺ said, "Inna ibni haza sayyidun." Because whatever happened before, it's gone. Okay. Now he brings them together. Okay. That means he is a valid, authentic leader. Okay. Did you get my argument?
Repeat
it in one sentence, very quickly.
You are saying you are saying basically that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam knew that Hassan ibn Ali is going to give bayah, and that you have to follow Muawiyah. Because Hassan ibn Ali gave bayah.
I'm not saying that.
Then what are you saying?
That's not my argument. So you're not listening.
I will say one thing.
Can you repeat my argument? Can you repeat my argument?
Argument?
Clearly, you're not listening now. You're not listening.
Kindly let me speak.
What's my argument?
Kindly let me speak.
But what's my argument? One sentence.
Your argument, I'm telling you again, is based on interpretation.
No problem. What is my argument? What is my argument?
That, you know, Sayyidina Hassan, he gave bayah out to...
They're not listening.
So that means...
They are not listening. Did you get my argument? Can anyone repeat? Wait. What's my argument? Listen to him. What's my argument?
The argument here is that the bayah of Hassan to Muawiyah is endorsed by
Allah. Wait. By who?
Endorsed by Allah.
Yes. Okay. And by...
My response to him is that...
Okay. Now, wait.
There is a mistake in the
Can you repeat my argument?
Okay.
Before we get to istidlal, Before we get to Istidlal or Istinbat, can you tell me what my argument is very quickly?
That
because I believe you're not listening. My word, you have gone Qadiani on me today.
No.
Yeah. Because Qadiani, you know, when I ask, when I jump Qadiani, you say, "Push down." One minute. When I ask them a question, they go, "Huh?" And they're so intelligent. They will be doctors, engineers, highly educated people. When I ask them a straight question about Mirza and his writings, his lies, huh?
What's your question to them?
Wait.
So don't do that. Don't do that to me today. Yaar, ye mere sath na karo.
Razi,
everyone,
relax.
Yes. Wait. So basically, you are saying.
Yes.
Basically, you are saying that Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan's Khilafat was endorsed by Allah and his Rasul and Hassan ibn Ali.
Allahu Akbar!
Okay.
Takbir!
Okay. Now my argument.
My argument has been understood.
Now let him speak.
Okay, now you tell me.
Let me speak. According to this argument, was Yazid correct or not? Was he on the...
Wait!
We don't care about Yazid.
No, that's my argument.
We do not
care.
Wait, no. Wait, relax.
Yazid was correct.
Relax.
Wait, I'm answering. Let
you see,
answer.
They're not following my argument.
I am following your argument. Wait.
I am going to...
My argument, you're not understanding. You don't even know what it is.
It's only about the Sulha.
Yazid. No. It's not about Sulha. It's about what happened there. What happened there? It's about what happened.
Was Yazid on the true path or he was on the false path?
Okay.
Yes or no? What's your answer?
Okay. We will definitely.
Are you against him or not?
Okay.
What kind of.
You finish.
Have you stopped beating your father?
What do you mean, don't do that?
It's like that. Yes,
you finish.
Yes or no?
Okay. Let me respond now.
Okay.
Let me respond. Yazid is a completely different case to Muawiyah. Completely different. We are not. Wait, wait.
Is he correct or not?
Deko, if you're not going to let me speak, you ask me a question. You ask me a question. First of all.
So don't come in, bro.
You. Relax. Relax. I want you. Why are you engaging with the public? Relax. I'm asking you a question. Is Yazid... I am not moving from Muawiyah. I'll tell you why.
I'm also not moving from Muawiyah.
No. We'll,
I just have a
you
question.
Are discussing... You're discussing... Oh my God. Allahu Akbar. Listen, you are jumping from point to point without establishing one point. My point is still valid.
My question.
Okay.
Was Yazid correct or not?
Okay.
That's my question.
Let's say... Okay, wait. My question. My question stands... Are you listening?
I'm listening.
Let's say Muawiyah came to power in the year 41 Hijri, on the 1st of Dhul Hijjah, for example. What happens after the 1st of Dhul Hijjah? Completely different chapter and question. Wait, relax.
Yes,
oh, wait,
yes.
Yaar. Wait, yes, relax.
Wait,
relax. Look, we're going to have to stop this.
No,
because it's not happening. It's not happening. Today, too many fights are kicking off. Too many fights are kicking off.
Adnan bhai, are honne do bhai. Aap mujhe ye bataiye. Was Yazid correct?
Aap nahi sun rahe meri baat. You're not listening to me.
Aapka argument sun liya, aap mera argument sun
rahe. Aapka argument relevant hi nahi hai.
Aap kaise judge kar sakte hain bina jane hue? Kya hai mera argument?
Main batata hu.
Pehle first argument bataiye. Aapne pehle bol diya ki relevant hai.
First, my point needs to be stated.
My point,
oh my God. You don't. Last week, pata kya ho raha tha? Log mujhe blame kar rahe the ki I'm not letting you speak. The problem is you keep cutting and you keep interrupting while I'm speaking.
You are bypassing many ahadiths.
No, I'm not.
Process.
I'm not.
Listen, and you have also supposedly put the assassination or murder of Ammar bin Yasir on Khawarij. We don't know who did that.
You're still not following my argument.
But we know the hadith.
You still don't know what I'm saying.
He said something else. You are both.
No.
What they're doing. I know what they're doing. They're jumping from crime to crime. They're jumping from crime to crime. In their eyes, these are crimes, and they cannot understand
my avalanche argument.
My avalanche argument is what? You know, your tractor blade hota hai na? Yeah, listen to me. Yaar, aap log sun nahi rahe. They are fighting each other.
I want to understand
basically,
what was his problem.
Adnan bhai's argument is
my problem is that he just took the khilafat.
You are not listening to me. You're not listening to me. You are wasting my time. Because you're not being intelligent. And I can see you're very intelligent people. But you have gone Qadiani on me today. Not that you're Qadianis. You have gone completely brain dead. Acha, now listen to me. I'm going to explain again. Very quickly. All the crimes you allege on Muawiyah's part have been wiped clean after Hassan gives bayah to him.
Okay.
Because the fact that Hassan gave bayah to him, that means sulh, number one, they have come together. Sulh means everything that's gone in the past, forgiven, forgotten, new chapter. Done? Okay, wait. Stop bringing those old crimes and start alleging the same things that Hassan himself knew and completely put aside for a greater good of the Ummah, which was what? Sulh and bayah. Okay? Now, stop hopping from Ammar, Siffin, Yazid, sub of Ali from the member. Stop doing that. Wait, relax. Wait. Relax. Yaar, meri Pakistan ka kuch nahi ho sakta. Pakistan ka kuch nahi ho sakta. Kyunki aise hi hum jaise log hain Pakistan.
Abu al-Khadiya is also absolved of the crimes.
I am not talking about them.
No. According to your hadith...
Brother, you have gone truly Qadiani on me today.
No.
You have completely gone Qadiani on me today. Now I'm okay. Mujhe danda. I need this. Wallahi, I need this.
They said if you give the match to the, you know what?
You know, this is why Muawiyah used this, because he was dealing with people.
Let Muawiyah, okay. Umar
and Muawiyah. Okay, wait.
You know what? By the joke.
Okay, there's a joke I have. Umar. A man came to Umar and he said, I don't understand this verse of the Quran.
Which is clear verse.
Okay, clear verse. So Umar said, put him in a bag and give him a few licks. You know, so they put him in a bag and they opened him.
No, wait.
They asked him, do you understand? He said, no. No, I don't understand. I said, put him back in the bag. So they put him back in the bag and gave him a few hits.
Harder.
Yeah. Second time they took him out, I said, hey, I understand completely now.
I'm so okay.
I think we need two bags, guys.
We need two bags? I think we need many.
We need one small and one big. Okay, listen, guys, listen. My argument is very simple.
You are just
not registering it. You are ignoring my argument. My argument is all the crimes you are talking about, Abu Ghadia, Ammar ibn Yasir Qatal, and the fighting. Listen, the bayah of Hassan, who was present in the battlefield, you are the kind of people. If you were present there, you would say to Hassan, you blackened our face. Because there were people, at the time, they came to Hassan, they said, people of Kufa, they said, you blackened our face. He's doing what Allah said, what the Prophet said, and what he thought was best.
The Prophet said the killer of Ammar is in fire.
Again,
that's
unbelievable. You're still talking about it.
No.
My argument.
Your argument is that you are bypassing all hadiths.
Come on, listen. That one hadith. Bhai, listen to me. That bayah happened after all these things. Are you so simple that you don't know what I'm saying? When I speak to Qadianis, they completely, my words come here, down.
I have a question.
Don't do that to me. Listen to me. I'm saying the bayah of Hassan.
You are against Yazid, right? Yes or no? You're against
Bhaijan.
You are against
Bhaijan.
Yazid.
I am Yazid.
That's my
argument. Okay.
Are you against
so
Yazid?
So we're discussing Yazid now.
Nahin, we're
you
want
to discuss Yazid?
I'm just asking you your opinion.
First, establish. Are we discussing Yazid?
No, I'm just asking you.
I need to go and pray.
Are you against Yazid? Yes or no?
Are we discussing
yes
Yazid?
Or no?
Yes, 100% yes or no. I'm against Yazid.
Against
yes.
Yazid?
Yes.
According to this, then, what's his name? We can also join dots.
Why are you going? Now relax, I need to speak to you. One second.
Yazid Khilafat.
Just one second.
So he was also innocent.
What happened there? That's his argument.
We can also join dots like this and we can make Yazid
wait, you leave. You have to leave?
Does that make sense? No.
I can call you, but can you wait for 2-3 minutes? Because now, I think they will make me brain dead as well. So before, guys, brothers and sisters, before I have a stroke, I have to.
You know what he's saying?
What?
He's saying that you're making Muawiyah ma'soom because you're establishing this new chapter.
No comment. I lose. I surrender. I submit. I lose. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
servant forever, you know, these people.